Granger and I have been lovers for several weeks.
Ooh.
Who's older?
What do you mean, ooh?
No, I'm sorry. I just got a little mental picture there. It took me by surprise.
That's Ted Danson in the beloved comedy classic, Cheers. The prolific Danson has a new show, and he's in conversation with Tracy Smith. What is it about this show?
Because I want people to see it. I really do. I think it's an important conversation.
It's strange to think of Ted Danson as nervous about anything. He's just worried about it. He's retired now. But in this case, it's not hard to see why.
Hello. Get out of my room, weirdo.
I know. His latest project means a lot to
me. I don't know how to be a spy.
And it touches everyone. Phones, camera glasses, recorder. Are you just tapping different parts of your body?
Yes. I left everything in my room. I'm just so excited.
In the new Netflix series, A Man on the Inside, Danson is a recently retired widower without much to do until he answers an ad from a private investigator and becomes a mole inside a nursing home.
What do you want me to do?
You would check into the community, pretending to be a new resident. I would give you various recording devices, and you would be my source, my mole.
A man on the inside.
Like a lot of TV series, the premise seems a little far-fetched, but this one's true. It's based on this, The Mole Agent, a 2020 documentary about a real-life 83-year-old who goes undercover in a Chilean nursing home, looking for signs of patients being mistreated.
No voy a contarte hoy día, basta hacer una tienda que todo.
What the documentary found was a group of elderly people fighting loneliness and loss with heart and humor. A Man on the Inside is no different, says series creator Mike Schur.
I would say the purpose of this show is simply to discuss a subject that very few people discuss, which is aging. It's the subject that we just don't like to talk about. It's thought of in this country, I think more than other countries, as something almost shameful or embarrassing.
You made a mistake. Good God, you somehow made a mistake.
See, you screwed up. Yeah, you screwed up. You got old, you know? And I think that's weird because this is what happens if we're lucky. If we're lucky, we get old.
I haven't done this for a long time. Walked along the beach.
Yeah. It's nice. At 76, Ted Danson himself is aging gracefully, with an attitude inspired by a Hollywood legend, Jane Fonda.
She was turning 80. And at 70, I was starting to go, well, I better look for a nice place to land, you know, this life plane or whatever. And I looked at her and I was like, no, she's her foot on the gas pedal. She's like doing a 12-hour day shooting her show, jumping on a bus to go, you know, support the service industry in Sacramento with a handful of women. Don't slow down. Just keep going. Keep living your life. I think that's one of the things our elders can pass on to us. This is how you live life right up until the end.
Seems like Ted Danson's elders set a good example. His parents wouldn't allow a TV in their home.
My mother didn't like me.
Because?
She'd rather you read or go out and play or be creative.
Sometimes you don't know where everybody knows you. But then Ted got famous on TV. Did they get a TV?
Yes, but they put kind of this beautiful tapestry over the front of it. So when you walk in their house, you're going to see a TV. You saw this beautiful tapestry with the candle on top. And they would take it off and watch Cheers.
So, who's next to chill us with a scary story, man?
Well, I think I have a chilling tale.
Yeah, but it's cute when you wiggle.
Truth is, the world watched Cheers. His success today to that one show about a Boston bar. But since he hung up his apron in 1993, he's been hit after hit. He was the title character in Becker.
She calls me the angry man. Me, you believe that? I like to take that stupid book and just run it down the floor.
I want you to feel the disgust in your children's eyes.
eyes when they look on you in shame.
In damages, he held his own with Glenn Close.
This is wild.
He went to heaven and hell in the good place.
It is a torture museum. Famous examples of bad behavior and explanations of the torture they earned.
Is there a gift shop?
Jason, this is hell. Of course it's a gift shop. Actually, you know what?
And he's even played himself. Quick, curb your enthusiasm.
I'm here to ask your permission if I can bait Cheryl. Boom.
Our oceans are in jeopardy of being fished out in commercial.
Along the way, Danson's used his fame to draw attention to his passion project, Oceana, an organization dedicated to preserving the world's oceans.
You feel like you've made enough progress in Oceana so far? I mean, you've done great work with plastics and things like that.
Yes, yes. I mean, our focus is on fishing, overfishing, making sure that the fisheries of the world are healthy, because if done right, you could feed a billion people a fish meal every day.
That sounds a little like a miracle. Something he touches on in his new show, and something he says he lives with every day.
I'm curious, in your life, what are the miracles?
Marriage steam merchant is literally heaven sent. I did some work on myself for about a year before I met her, after Cheers, you know, becoming emotionally mature and real. And I worked hard at it, and then along came Mary Steenburgen, but she, you know, that's why. We are so blessed to love somebody, and to be loved is just one of those heaven on earth miracles, and that came with Mary.
And the idea Ted Danson is hoping to share with his latest project.
Let me go to Furley of Sin, and in pure fun to not catch your head down again.
Is that miracles can be found in any life, right up until the very end.
This is your life. Not just up to, you know, 65 and then you retire and then you go back. No, you get to live right up until you don't live. And it's your life. It's such a gift. Explore it and be excited about it. Yes, it hurts. Yes, it's sad. Yes, there's grief. Yes, there's all of that. But embrace it. Embrace it is kind of what I think the message of the show is. It's what I hope I live with.
Embracing it.
Yeah. Yeah.
It gets you a little emotional.
I'm just emotional because I finally said something I wanted to say.
I'm the master of reptiles.